I duck out of frame, it's because I'm wiping my nose.
I'll just do it. Okay. I think it's finally working. Yes, it is working.
Yay!
Yeah, goodness. We had technical difficulties. Yeah, we're all here.
Lindsey should be in front because she's small.
Yeah, maybe we should
arrange. Don't crouch. I'm taller than you, Lindsey. It's fine.
Oh, and I just got to do. Was that another text message? Oh, I see.
I mentioned you on Twitter. Maybe that's
okay.
Right.
Oh, no. It's actually my working. Asking. Yes, when it is working.
Yay! Yeah.
Call us when there's pizza.
Yeah, goodness.
We had technical difficulties. Cool. Yeah, we're all here.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
We're live.
Yeah, we're live. We're so sorry that we're like late, but I'm gonna tell you.
I mentioned you on Twitter.
My internet is down.
Oh no.
It's finally my work.
Frustrating.
Yes, it is working.
Yay!
You were very
good.
So yeah, we had.
I was very authoritative.
Yeah, we're all here. Hi, guys.
I know you have to say that, but
yeah, we're live. Yeah,
I said to the guy, I said, "Do you realize
it's so? We're so sorry that we're like late, but I'm going to tell you, my internet is down.
Oh,
good. Yeah, there's a bunch of people.
It is though, and I see that lots of people are coming from.
You can see the comments.
Comments on the side.
We're so sorry that we're like late, but
my internet is
down.
Oh, good. Yeah, there's a bunch of people. It is though, and I see that lots of people are coming from.
You can see the comments.
You can shoot
guys.
Another
reason. Comments on the side.
I'm not sure that's good.
Yeah.
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 How's that? I bet you that's better. Because I have this is my microphone, and it was on too. So I've just muted this, and now we're only using that audio.
Okay.
Sorry, guys.
Finally.
Okay. Cool.
Thomas.
There you go. Hey, Thomas.
I can't hear anything.
Now you can't.
It's not showing any audio now.
No, but it should be. Oh wait, no, it is fine. Okay,
Yeah.
So it's okay.
Good.
You can hear us. Please say yes. We can.
And we're not echoing.
Yeah.
Sound is fine.
Thomas, you came in at the right
Thank
time.
Thank you. Okay, that was hilarious. So I guess we were talking about
industry rates.
Well, and then here's the other thing that you were mentioning, right? Like about like maybe $300 or $400 or $1,000 sounds like a lot, but the average number of days that a Canadian actor works in a year is 2 days.
Yeah. You spend way more time, trying to get the work than actually working. And that's kind of what they're paying you for, is that time that you need to spend to do that, because you can't take a regular job and be unavailable when those auditions.
Yeah. And you have like how many jobs, Lindsey, you were saying?
Seven jobs.
I've got a few
jobs on the go now. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you're focusing mostly on creating work right now, and so am I.
But I'm always taking any kind of gig I can get just to make ends meet. It's not a cush life by any means.
No.
It's a question from me.
Yeah, it's coming. Mm-hmm. It's coming.
Where is Thomas?
The suspense.
Send us your question. We're excited to answer them.
I need to know.
We can hear you. No way. Yes, we're all good. Good. Oh, no way. I bet you that no way was to the thing about the number of days. Mm. Okay, so while we're waiting for that question, I actually wanted to show. I was thinking maybe sharing, because like here, you haven't seen this. Well, yeah, because you guys aren't patron. You know, because you're not on the system. I've been asking Patreon to like set it up so that other cast members and crew members can join us. And so, you guys haven't been reading what the patrons of Out with Dad are saying about the episode. So yeah, that's a very polite. That's very nice thing. Larissa's saying.
Thanks, Larissa.
Yeah. Yep. So, French subtitles, I think, are there now. Here's the live premiere thing. So yeah, you guys, I don't know if you know this. I hosted a thing like this, and I just watched the episode with them when I debuted it.
Right.
Where's the other one? I did a little bloggy post. So I'm just kind of sharing this with you so you guys kind of know what kind of stuff. Actually, I suppose I can spread this out like that. Make that a little bit bigger. That's probably easier to read. I'm just sharing this with you guys so you can understand some of the cool things that the patrons get to see. Lots of comments here on the 45 comments. Yeah, wow. So there's lots of people really love it. Like, so I don't know, maybe you don't want, patron alert. Oh yeah, I know, that's not a spoiler. Yeah, but you know, people are stoked about the, reconciling, what do we call that episode? Yeah, reconciling with Claire. So people are digging this episode, so I'm super happy about that.
It's so great to have her in Toronto.
Yeah. And it was funny, we were just talking about like that was already seems like a long time ago.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
We're all like confused.
That was the last time we saw each other.
I completely forgot. I haven't seen you since Christmas, Lindsey.
Yeah. So let's move this way and see what others are saying here. So
Kate feel about being the lead in Orphan Black? What?
I think Tatiana kind of has dibs on that.
Yeah.
She wants to hand it over, I'm happy to take it.
Yeah, you could take it.
She's pretty amazing at it. Like, she deserves all of the accolades that she's gotten.
Oh, big
she's
time.
An incredible actress, but yes.
You know, maybe just one of the clones.
Sure, right? You want to hear actually a funny story? I used to roommate with the girl who plays, who actually stands in as her stand-in. Catherine Alexander was my roommate, and she, whenever you're watching the clones of Orphan Black, that's my roommate, Catherine Alexander, standing there being
That's great, because Laura Jabley was her roommate at one time, too.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
We're all connected.
So here's an interesting, so what are you up to while not shooting? So, I mean, like sometimes it's as exciting as serving tables. One of the things I'm doing is I'm trying to get another project off the ground, like a sort of an interactive 3D virtual reality type thing, and it's gonna be super badass. It's gonna be awesome. I can't wait to do that. So today, actually, these guys are joining me because I'm gonna be hosting a writing room today. So we're gonna brainstorm ideas. I got lots of writers on board because I want lots of people. So that's kind of exciting. And you're pitching all sorts of things.
Yeah, I've been writing, and also I've been spending a lot of time with the IAWTV, which is the nonprofit Academy of Web Television, and we're working with Just for Laughs right now, and we are selecting web series that'll get to pitch to CBC and College Humor and places like that. And it's really exciting, and it's going to be tons of fun, and it's a lot of work.
Actually, Kate and I, we actually re-pitched that show, But How Do You Have Sex, that we pitched last year. So we resubmitted that to them and see, so wish us luck.
And I cannot comment on that.
Yeah.
But they did ask about Lindsey. What Lindsey's up to with Happy Her.
Talk about Happy Her.
So for those of you who don't know, I also make my own web show, hopefully soon to be TV show. That's what I'm frantically working on right now, where my best friend and I travel around the world and we ask women what makes you happy. So yeah, I think the question was, how was your travel? Yeah. Oh. Fabulous. Can't wait to go again.
By the way, so she...
look at you. Yeah, I'm also on Patreon.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean,
thanks,
you know...
Jason.
Yeah. I encourage you to get on there. I know some of the Emma Dad...
Yes,
like, I know, like,
Thomas
is in there, a few others.
Emma is...
I am?
No.
Yeah, I'm a patron of yours.
Yeah. It's great. I love it. It's a very fun show, and it's just, we need a lot more love in this world, so that's all I'm trying to do.
Yeah,
so,
really good.
What
are we, someone is asking, I'm a little behind, can't wait to watch Reconcile. Yeah, really, I can't wait for us to, share them all, so, I hope everyone doesn't mind us being, it's the carrot at the end of the stick. Like, we're just trying to encourage more patronage to be like, hey, if we can do this, then we can really do this and get it out there sooner and faster.
Someone says, what was your first job? Do they mean
acting?
Andrea, do you mean acting, or do you mean just in life?
In life.
Mine's very different.
My first job actually was, I was a manager of a movie theater in Oakville.
Oh, yeah.
It's not the same location, but the same movie theater that we actually shot, we've shot in front of Dad.
Yeah.
That was my first job.
Wow.
So that's play. It's
what was yours?
I was a paper boy.
Yeah, right on.
Door to door, carrying the shopping cart around with 200 copies of the Toronto Star, and
that's gonna be a legacy job. Like,
I know.
What are newspapers today?
Yeah. I was a soccer referee.
No way.
Yeah.
How old were you?
I think I was 12. Yeah. But like, I did the tots.
Yeah.
So it's basically just like kids running in a clump, and I would just be like, oh, the ball's out, you have to throw it in. So that was all it was. So it was fun. I like soccer.
Cool. What was your first job?
I was a cashier at a mom and pop drugstore. I basically sat on the shelf and read magazines for free all day. It was wonderful.
I will be okay with that.
Yeah. People magazine, 17, I read all the greats.
The greats.
What else have we got going on here online?
In life and acting. Okay, what was your first acting job?
My first acting job.
A good story.
The very short version of it, I was in Good Will Hunting opposite Robin Williams, and it was a total dream come true. And I was kind of brought in as an extra, as a background player in his classroom with 12 people in it. And then on the spot, I was given something specific to do and a bit of a line, which did not make the final cut. But the experience of doing it was unbelievable. Working with Robin Williams, he was everything people said about him. Really a sweet guy that gave everything. And he didn't go back to his trailer between takes. He actually just did stand-up comedy for 20 minutes while they were doing the next setup to this room full of 12 people. It was amazing. Just amazing.
So,
that was my first experience. There's the full story about it on... an episode of Super Geeked Up you can watch.
Yeah.
The tribute to Robin Williams.
We should try and find... Oh, yeah. So if you Google that, it is a real... I've watched it. It's really touching. So yeah, if you YouTube search Super Geeked Up tribute to Robin Williams...
You'll find it.
You'll find it very easily. Yeah. Yes, I bet she was a boss referee.
I was the boss. Andrea, I was the boss.
Oh, that's a great question to ask. How much stage acting have each of you done?
Well, Lindsay's done all of it.
All of it.
Yeah. How many shows are you in right now?
This year alone, I've already done 1, 2, 3. I'm currently rehearsing 2. I'm definitely doing 1 in September. And then I have potentials for, I don't know, the October and October?
Cool.
A lot. I love the stage.
You've never done the stage, right?
Not really. I did improv comedy, but not traditional theater.
And of course, you've been on the stage recently.
Yeah, like the recently-ish. Yeah, I was doing the Second City Conservatory, which was really, really fun. And I actually met a lot of people in the comedy world that I'm now working with making film stuff. Like, they've all helped me with my other web series, Kate Conway is a Jerk. And then I've got another thing in the works that I'm writing for and going to be in. I can't remember the name, what's it called, but I'll post it when it's done. Yeah. It's going to be more sketches that I've will be writing with some friends of mine that I made at Second City. So.
Good, good. We and actually, I ran into one of your classmates, Pete, the other day.
Oh, Pete, because
he was in, was it the last episode of Kate Conway's a Jerk? Yeah, it was the last one. Yeah. And he's so funny. But anyway, I'm going to get him in on this VR thing because I figure I'll get him to corral because I know one of the tables. I just want funny people. Yeah. So I was just like, here, I'll probably
you
not.
Just sit Pete down and make him talk and he'll
and action.
Non-stop laughter. Yeah.
One day I saw Lindsey Middleton over at Dundas and Bay. It was like, oh my God.
I'm going to say hi next time. Totally hi. That would have made my day.
Yeah. So, I think everyone's had like a good like run-in story.
Yeah.
My favorite one of yours was
the airport.
The airport.
The airport one was a good one at
in
LAX.
Los Angeles. Yeah.
But no, the more recent one where you were
in High Park.
But there was like another famous person in the room, and who was
it? Oh, in Boston.
Oh, you were in Boston.
There was someone in Boston. If you're watching now, say something. It was Adam Baldwin from Firefly and Chuck was in this cafe, and I'm like, oh, it's cool, Adam Baldwin, that's kind of cool. And then although I've heard some things about him, maybe not so cool, but
we're fans of his work,
right? And a little later someone comes up to me and goes, excuse me, are you from Out With Dad? And you know, and I'm like,
you can recognize the most.
I'm actually more famous than Adam Baldwin in this scenario.
To this person, yes.
So, that's that was amazing.
Cool. That was kind of cool.
Yeah, no, actually, yeah, I think Jonathan, yeah, does get recognized. Well, he's like goes everywhere, like
yeah.
He's like,
always around. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I guess we got the Toronto
and Kate, not as often, I think.
No, because, I mean,
but actually, especially with your one gig, you've run into fans.
Hotel?
Yeah,
yeah, awkward. <'Cause> I work as a hotel concierge. I'm like there to answer your questions about Toronto. So it's like if you want to visit the CN Tower, the museum, you come to me, and then people will be like, oh, I recognize you from the show. I'm like, oh, great. You want me to tell you how to get to the CN Tower? Like, yeah. So it's a little weird.
That's funny.
Someone likes my YouTube channel.
Oh, good, yeah. good.
I love you.
It's we are making more.
We're
suits,
going to
right?
my life has finally come to where it's supposed to be. So
which
I
is terrifying because
now
I'm like getting swamped. So we'll figure it out.
It's fine.
We'll
it's fine.
It, we'll
like,
make it work.
Had a blast.
Okay.
What else have we got there? Let me read this stuff.
I like this one from Fab Jame. What was the best advice you've ever received?
Best acting advice?
No, advice.
Oh, advice.
In life. That's a great question, Jason.
Are we using this mic?
No, it's a prop.
It's a prop mic.
best advice I ever got. You know, okay, it's recent advice, so it's really sticking with me, is that you really have to think about time, especially in this indie filmmaking world. You have to consider time as currency. And actually the way we've been budgeting season 4 has really helped me do that because I'm paying attention to my hours literally more. So I think that's something is that, you know, you have to value your time. Like it's great to be doing volunteering and stuff, but like know what you're worth. I think that's
important.
I think that's been my latest thing. I'm still learning this advice, but that's it.
Otherwise it's a hobby, right?
Which is what I would have started as.
Sure.
Right. And now it's a job and I still forget that I slip into hobby mode and it's like, no, this is a job. It's a job I get to love. Yeah. Like you're
You're allowed to love your job.
You're allowed to, yeah. I mean, this is why you have seven.
She loves all of them.
Yeah, I love them all.
I don't know if this is the best advice I've ever been given, but what comes to mind, I was recently on set around Alexander Payne, who directed About Schmidt, The Descendants, and Election with Reese Witherspoon. And this one he's directing with Matt Damon, and he was directing Matt Damon. And he said, you know, I just want you to remember that in film, the most you do is the least you do. And then just kind of chew on that for a bit. And so I've been chewing on that for a bit.
And you chewed on that when we were filming today, weren't you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very much.
Yeah. Because you did a good job today.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks, Alexander.
Probably two pieces of advice. One is
no, you lied to one.
No, just
fine.
Give me two.
I have two.
The first one is basically like I can't remember who said it. Probably every acting teacher ever had is be over prepared. Always, because there's going to be someone even more prepared than you. So know all your lines backwards and forwards. You should be saying them in your sleep, blah, blah, blah. That was really good. But my favorite piece of advice was from a fellow web series actress, Nicole Stamp, was my on-camera teacher. And she, the first class, we just kind of sat down and shot the shit. Like, she's so cool. She's in Carmella, right? That's the one she's in, right?
Carmella. Is she in it?
Carmella,
oh, okay, yeah.
But she was basically like, the best piece of advice I could give you, I think this is what she said was the best piece, was be the nicest person on set. Be the person who brings the Timbits. They remember the person who brings the Timbits. Always strive to
Timbits for you non-Canadians.
Yes, they're donut holes. But like basically it's like we've all run into people on set that it's like, why are you such a jerk? Why are you such a diva? It's the people
we've had those people on this show and like they're not involved in the show anymore. Like
But like you want to keep working with the people.
Well, now they're all gonna be trying to figure out who.
You know what? Those people aren't watching this because they're not involved. They're not the nice people. Like they don't, you know, they weren't invested. So
just treat the person that's booming, miking you up and doing your makeup and getting your coffee is just as important as the director.
And this isn't advice for actors. This is for advice for
anyone.
Oh, I
follow this
industry.
In life. Like you.
Well, in life, certainly. Yeah. Yes. Yes. But like, I think that it's especially true because there's a certain culture that is a film crew and cast. Like it's a, you know, there is a sense of family that ends up happening. And sometimes that doesn't happen. Mm-hmm. And it's because like, you know, there's not enough Timbit bringers.
Exactly.
And, you know, and
those donut holes, they go down easy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyways, Lindsey, advice.
My advice, two really quick things. The worst thing anyone's ever going to say to you is no. So just ask them because they might say yes to whatever you want, your craziest dreams. And then the other one is I tell myself every day, you have more than enough time, because I tend to get really wrapped up in this idea that everything needs to happen right away, and then it's stressful, and then it's not enjoyable, so I just have to relax and say, you have more than enough time to do this, and then get it done.
I think I need to write that one down.
It's
<'Cause laughs>
my daily mantra.
We need it.
Retiring the mic.
I don't know. I don't know if I can even follow that, because I'm terrible.
No, you can.
Because actually, that's my biggest fault as a filmmaker, is that I am the worst time manager. Like, totally terrible.
So many comments I can't read.
When
you
have a kid, as well, it's hard, you know.
Yeah. We I think we're actually still okay for time, because we have to be out of here. We have to leave here for our meeting by 1:00. We still have to eat, and so we should probably wrap up in maybe 10 minutes.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. So you got 10 minutes, guys. Any questions? Someone did ask, "How did you become an actor, actress?" That was a question.
Oh, was that Nicole Stamp that had a cameo in Orphan Black? Is that what the comment is?
Oh, cool.
Right on.
And why did you create Outlet Dad? That you know what? It's funny because one of the lines we shot today, I was talking about, I remember, I think it was
me.
You. There's a line, all sorts of different scenes that we shot today. It's crazy. We had more than enough time. I should have been saying that, because we were like trying to do too many things at once, and I was like a little fuzzy. But I wanted to provide a positive role model. Like that was kind of like why I wanted to make it, because back when I first started, before I started the show, I did a little bit of research just to see like what, from a parental perspective, like what should a parent be thinking about and be doing when they think their kid is struggling with coming out. And the stuff I found was like really negative. Like it was stuff like how to fix your kid, like how to make him straight. Like that's what most of the stuff I was finding was. I mean, it's totally different now, fortunately. But it's like when I saw that, I'm like, okay, then we have to like set a positive example. And so like that's why I made it is like, even though the characters are flawed and like, you know, like we all agree that Rose really screwed up, you know, at tail end of season three. And, you know, we've all, you know, all the characters have made bad decisions at some point in time, but they're very human decisions.
Yeah, they're human.
But the way everyone treats each other, I think that's I think that that's the positive role model I want this show to be about. What else have we got here, guys?
Lies. Even when they let someone down, there's always respect underneath that, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. I think so. Yeah.
What are your favorite scenes?
Any meetups? Should we do a meetup? Never done a meetup.
We have, yeah, we did like at the museum that one time.
We did do
and
a
few other things. Yeah, no, every now and then. That's too bad, yeah, because like, well, but you know, there are always the Toronto Web Series meetups, and we try and go to those as much as we can. And I think there's one coming up in
soon. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah, what's that? Read it to me.
Where do you see the show going? Will there be a season 5? Your show really helped me and my friend come out.
Oh, great. Oh Rosie, I'm glad that we were there for you.
Her name's Rosie.
Yeah, that's right. Mm. There's a, you haven't, we haven't shot the scene yet, but I actually have a line there where Rose says, okay, just don't call me Rosie.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's Vanessa 2.0 says back, oh, why do people call you that? And she's like, no, I'm just, now I feel embarrassed. It's another one of those Rose moments. So anyway, sorry. Will there be season 5? The answer to that is very simple, because like, no, we're just going to keep doing season 4. Like, we're just going to keep doing season 4. Because like, why count?
It's nomenclature.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I don't know. Like, in a way, like, seasons are such a television thing, because the season is like, it was based on the years, the time of the year, and
sure,
you know, block, and you know, and also, or another way you could look at it, you know, this is a more British way of looking at it, is, you know, a season is simply, or they would say a series is just a block of shooting.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now that Outlet Dad isn't doing blocks,
now that we're on Patreon,
it's just like in a way, like it's the infinite season, so that's what that is. So as for where I see the show going, I think that the theme for season 4 right now is a lot about resolving and reconciling feelings and really learning to be true to yourself. So that's kind of like what the themes are. I don't want to say anything more than that, with that, because then we get into spoiler territory, because I'm also forgetting, like, how much have we shot? How much is only written that you guys haven't even read yet?
How much has been released?
You know, because, like, I have up through to April 2017, like, more or less written. So, like, I know that far ahead. So, that's a lot, yeah.
I think it's fair to say, like, you know, right from the beginning of the season, there's been very much with Rose and Nathan this trying to figure themselves out. How do they exist as
both grown-ups.
Daughter, but both being grown up now.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's been a big theme for me. But also separate from them, even though it's a different timeline, is Vanessa's like dealing with, okay, well, I guess I'm a grown up too. So it is a lot of like, you know, everyone's dealing with, okay, now I'm a grown up, but even so is Nathan, because he's like really, you know, he didn't mourn very well, did he?
Right. Yeah. They put it off for so long.
Yeah. So what other questions have we got there? Lindsey, you're closest.
When is the next live stream? Are we gonna do this again? Probably.
Sure.
Well, if you're a patron, we do live streaming for every, like, we're going back in time. I think.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Two?
Yeah. Okay. By the way, yeah. So this is an opportunity for me to do some big apologizing, because I'm behind in those. So one of the perks for patrons of $10 or more is to participate in monthly live streams. So this is like an anomaly. Like, I decided to open it to everyone just because I want everyone to kind of know about it. And in those ones, I open it up, and it's just me, but I try and get like one of you guys to join me whenever we can. But then what we'll do is we'll watch an episode at the same time and just do commentary about that episode. So like, that's a thing, you know, you'll eventually see those get posted later. So a lot of those are posted, but even those, like, some of them are recorded, but I haven't made them public yet. Like, I mean, I'm just behind because I'm not good at time management. That's why.
Can I answer this one?
Yeah, what's that?
So Caitlin Mines says to Kate, thanks to you, I had the courage to come out to my family. Thank you for being you.
Aww.
Who are your acting inspirations? Well, first, congratulations.
That's wicked.
On behalf of all of us, we love you. We wish you the best.
Yeah.
My acting inspirations, I don't know. I grew up like digging Judy Garland in The Wizard of Oz. That was probably like my first person. Cool. And then as an adult, I'm more into comedy. So like Tina Fey, Amy Poehler, like they're just rock stars.
But not just because they're Tina Fey and et cetera. Mm-hmm. They're not just because they're great actors, but also because they're great writers and creators.
Yeah.
Like they're all
just, they're so smart. They're smart women who like, they want you to appreciate them for their brains. And it's like, that's what I'd like people to appreciate me for. Yeah. Cause that's where, you know, my acting comes out of my brain. So,
yeah.
So yeah, so that's me. And then of course this one right here is so inspirational because she's never stops working. So she, Lindsey kicks my ass and makes me want to work harder. So I love her for that.
Thanks.
Well, I'm all for club now.
Lindsey actually really is a phenomenal actress. I got to film a couple auditions that she did, and like watching her do Shakespeare, it's just, she's unbelievable.
Well,
hate Shakespeare, but when she does it, it's
amazing. We get to see Lindsey do a lot, don't we? You know, because you guys don't get to see everything because, like, you know, it's on stage a lot of it. So
you miss out on me being funny.
Yeah,
I'm funny.
But the thing that we're going to write today, I want that to be a chance to be funny. I really do.
Oh,
I think it'd be funny. So Lindsey's going to be the lead in that. And but in a way that's going to almost know the, it's going to be weird. It's going to be
exciting.
It's a different way of thinking. It's actually, if you can imagine, it's a cross between film and theater. Like
that. Should be the anchor in it. You can say that, right?
Yeah. Yeah. The anchor, that's a good way of putting it. / host. No, I think anchor's better. Oh. Yeah, that's a good word. I find it difficult to get another. It's great. But to find, difficult to find other web series that are as great. Well, you know what? There are some. Mm-hmm. I saw a really cute one at TO Webfest that I really enjoyed. And they're newer filmmakers. And it's called Hired Help. And it's about a girl who I think she's out at the beginning of the show, and but she's having troubles, like, you know, she's in love with her best friend sort of thing, and she's straight, and so her guardian angel comes to like help her, but her guardian angel's kind of an asshole and doesn't like her, and it's really funny. Like, it's very sweet, and I, you know, so they screened a couple episodes at TO Webfest, and you know, very, very sweet show, and that's one made here in Toronto.
At IAWTV.org, our spotlight this month is on an LGBT web series, and I can't for the life of me remember the name of it right now, but I had not heard of it until we found it for the spotlight. So check out IAWTV.org, and you might discover a new one.
It's that's good. I just totally started crying. Oh, you made someone cry.
I'm sorry.
Any advice on starting a web series and funding? Kickstart Arts is right. So that is a very common question, but I don't know how to answer that today because it is changing so much. Like the way Out With Dad did it is one story, but I don't think that it would work anymore because when we started, one of the reasons why our third season Kickstarter worked and our fourth season Patreon works is because we'd already spent 3 years of our lives doing it for free, and we built the audience. And so, like, I think any step in terms of getting funds from an audience, step one is build that audience. So and how do you fund yourself to do that? That's a question I don't know how to answer. Cause like, here we are trying to start our next things. Like, we're all trying to start our next projects, and we are still struggling with the same question. The project that we're going to work on today, like the way we're doing that, we're sort of borrowing the pay model from season 4 in that everyone's going to be having like shares of the revenue, but like, that's going to be a show that we're going to sell. So right there, that's how we know we're going to pay for it, but we're not paying anyone up front, and whatever costs there are up front, like rentals and food and that kind of thing, like that's going to come out of my pocket because that's the only option right now. And then, you know, the revenue will pay me back, and then I get to start paying other people. But, you know, it sucks, but that's kind of like the best we can come up with, you know? So, So anyway, that's it. You know, definitely a disappointing answer, I'm sure.
But if you go to TO Webfest, they have lots of good panels and you can learn.
Yeah, yeah, because I gather if you're talking region part, you're a local. So, yeah. So, I mean, it's too bad you didn't make it this year. But, what do we got?
This question is kind of interesting. Are you guys going to cover asexuality on Out With Dad?
Oh, I don't have the opportunity to cover that yet.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like one of the things I am excited is the fact that we're still just like grazing the top of discussing bisexuality.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's been there in the plan since the first day of filming. Like, you know, we've always known that Lindsay's character is bisexual, but like it's never really been overtly stated, right? Mm-hmm. And so like finally we're at that point where I don't know if it's been, you know, I mean, we all know that now, but
we filmed something.
We did, yeah. I don't know if it's out yet. It's not out whatever. Yet. Well, maybe it is. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Point is, Vanessa didn't even know what that word herself meant. So, like, she didn't know she was bisexual, you know? Would that ever be on TV? Is that the goal? It was never the goal, but it is now. Because I think, you know, there is an opportunity. There are more and more web series that are being adapted for television. And that is something I'm pursuing, which is actually, again, you know, I keep saying about how busy and frazzled my brain is lately. That's one of the reasons that I've been so frazzled is I'm trying to build the material for that. And so that is something I'm working on doing. So that, you know, the next step is, you know, associated with a production company. There's a whole bunch of things to be done. And it'll be my first time trying to get into the television industry. So there's a lot to learn.
That's it's a sure. lot. I'm doing it right now.
Yeah, you're doing it too. Yeah, it's a lot. It's crazy. Yeah, so
at the time you started making Out With Dad, the part of the point is that it would never be on television.
Yeah, I did not want it to
now
be
changing.
Right? Yeah, yeah. And well, and you know, I started doing it on the web because I didn't know how to get into television. And also this kind of story wouldn't be tellable on television.
Wouldn't have gone for it.
It is now tellable on television, and now, you know, like now I have, you know, grown as a professional, my network is bigger and all that kind of stuff. So it's like, it's, you know, it's doable now. Whereas even like this time last year, I wouldn't have felt confident enough to do it. Yeah. So there, I guess I just realized we should wrap things up, but like maybe we'll answer one or two more questions and then we'll call it quits.
Sure.
Yeah.
Do we have any more? Yeah,
I thought I just saw a question mark. Oh no, I'm just rereading the, this is the best Q&A ever that I ever experienced.
Wow.
You're welcome.
You're from Toronto. I'm so sad you didn't say hi in the streetcar.
Yeah. Next time.
Crush.
But yeah, what else? You know, actually, we should, I'm wondering if there is a scene coming up. Maybe what we should do is we should put it out there that like some local, this is actually a really good idea. Okay, I got to think this through, so I may not do this, but I have a scene coming up that we need to shoot. It's the episode that would be due next week. I've sent you and Vanessa Salazar the scripts.
Oh, yes.
Where
I haven't looked at it.
Where they get, of course, she hasn't looked at it yet.
No.
Okay, it's a little bit spoilery, but it's not like plot spoil. You know, it's not, I'm not going to ruin the show for you. But they go to a gay bar together. And it would be really nice to populate, like to have our fans of the show be extras. So if you're local in Toronto, then maybe you can do that. So, you know, if you're into that, why don't you email me and just like, you know, it may not happen, this idea, but just email me, you know, jason@outwithdad.com you know, at least let me know, you know, you've got something for me to read aloud?
I got one.
Oh, good.
Since creating your own material, do you prefer to be behind the scenes now or in front of the camera or both?
Good. Well, this is a question for both of you. So well, all three of you.
Yeah,
we're all creators here.
Yeah. Yeah. Lindsay, she's...
yeah.
I definitely I think it's easier, not that it's easy, to be in front of the camera because that's what I know. Being behind the camera, it's a different muscle and it's a different brain. I really enjoy creating. I don't enjoy the business because that's just not where my training is. So I feel like I'm fumbling through that. But luckily, I'm surrounded by a lot of people who are helping me with that.
But you, okay, so I also don't enjoy the business.
Yeah.
that part sucks. Anyone will agree with that. But do you enjoy the craft of, like you know, you're a good production coordinator, I've asked you guys if you ever wanted to direct before. You both said no to that, I think.
No, I've changed my mind.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Awesome.
Cool. Yeah. Cool.
I really want to get into that more, like, that's been so long ago. But I just feel like I know more. Mm-hmm. Like, I feel like I'm at a level where I can be like, yeah, I understand that.
Mm-hmm.
Good. I know what's going on.
Good.
But yeah, I like it both.
Your career is longer than a lot of ours.
I started just as an actor.
Let me rephrase. Yeah, your career is longer in that you've been doing both for longer than any of us. Right. And so like, do you have a favorite in front of or behind the camera?
When I'm directing, I'm at home. When I'm acting, I'm at home.
Ah.
I think I really do love both equally, but they are very different. Mm-hmm. So it's another way of being creative. And ultimately I started directing as a way of creating an acting role for myself, and then found, you know what, this would be much better if I did this and let someone else do the acting so that I can keep them separate. And I do like to keep them separate because they are so different. I have a great respect for actors that can direct themselves, but I think that's just too much.
Yeah.
It's such I love the collaboration.
Well even Mike Donis has said that too, he plays Pete Winning and he co-directed Pete Winning. And the reason I became a co-director of that was because he's like, for the scenes that I'm in, I just need that person that's separate from Pete Winning, the character, to be able to make it work better. And I totally get that. I can't imagine it. Lots of people are interested. That's a cool idea. So don't get your hopes up on that idea. I think it's a cool idea. I think it's possible. But I plan to shoot the scene at the new YouTube space that we have here in Toronto. And the way it's set up is like, the whole space doesn't look like a bar. Only a portion of it is. So I have to be very choosy about the angles that we use to really sell it as a bar. And to make it worthwhile for you guys to be in the scene, I'm going to want to open up the frame so we can see more extras. Mm-hmm. And then that may no longer, so then it may not work as a bar anymore. And and it doesn't actually really, we have to do some art deck to sort of gay it up a bit, you know, throw in some rainbows and stuff like that.
Pride.
There'll be plenty of rainbows to find in the next little bit. So we'll be shooting in, you know, a Monday in July.
Okay, yeah, we should probably nail that down soon.
Yeah, we should talk about that. So
much of low budget filmmaking is just knowing what you have available to you, mm-hmm. and then working around that. So, yeah. You guys mm-hmm. expressing the interest is
yeah, like great. The scenes we shot today, it was because we had access to a space like that, and otherwise I wouldn't have written that scene, you know. So I guess we should wrap up because we have to get going, and now I'm worried about when we'll eat. Thanks guys, this was super fun. We'll do this again, you know.
Yeah.
maybe every couple months or something like that. I had fun.
Thank
goodbye
you. Bye. Bye.